Antenatal magnesium sulfate for the neuroprotection of preterm infants. Infants who are born premature have higher risks of dying. For the survivors, they face higher risks of morbidities, particularly neurological impairments. The most common neurological impairments in preterm infants include cerebral palsy and cognitive dysfunction. Prematurity and having very low birth weights actually account for 17 to 32% of all CP cases. Acquiring intraventricular hemorrhage and periventricular leukomalacia also increases the risks of developing cerebral palsy. Observational studies have shown that magnesium sulfate administered to women at risk for preterm births reduced the incidences of intraventricular hemorrhage in their preterm infants. The possible neuroprotective mechanisms of magnesium sulfate include prevention of neuronal excitotoxicity, regulation of vascular tone in both fetus and uterus, stabilization of membranes and reduction in free radicals, regulation of the glycolytic cycle, effects on platelet aggregation, and effects on inflammation. In 2010, Doyle et al. Published a Cochrane review entitled Magnesium Sulfate for Women at Risk of Preterm Birth for Neuroprotection of the Fetus. The background of the paper mainly focuses on the risks of neurological impairments, especially cerebral palsy, in premature infants. The objective of this meta-analysis is to assess both the effectiveness and safety of magnesium sulfate as a neuroprotective agent in preterm delivery. This Cochrane review selected randomized controlled trials comparing outcomes of premature infants from mothers who were given antenatal magnesium sulfate, either intravenously, intramuscularly, or orally, as compared to controls who were given placebo. The authors looked at outcomes for both infants and mothers, with primary outcomes of infants including death, neurological impairments, and combined outcomes of both death and neurological impairments. For the women, the primary outcomes looked at were adverse cardiovascular or respiratory outcomes and adverse effects severe enough to stop treatment. The authors did a literature search of the Cochrane Pregnancy and Childbirth Groups Trial Register. They used statistical analysis on the collected data to derive the relative risks and confidence intervals. Statistical heterogeneity between trials were tested using I-square statistics. The five trials selected in this review are Crowther 2003, Mittendorf 2002, Marit 2006, Rouse 2008, and Magpie 2006. To note, the first four trials specifically targeted women likely to undergo preterm birth, and magnesium sulfate was used in these trials for neuroprotection of the infants. On the other hand, Mittendorf also had a tocolytic arm in their study, in addition to the neuroprotective arm. The fifth study, Magpie, was designed to evaluate whether magnesium sulfate prevented eclampsia in preeclamptic women, but look at the long-term development of the infants as a secondary outcome. This is a summary of the five trials. Even though there were different endpoints, all of them were randomized controlled trials looking at death and long-term neurological outcomes of the infants. There were differences in the regimen that they used and the gestational age of the fetuses. However, subgroup analyses that were done for gestational age and dose of magnesium sulfate given showed no substantial differences between the treatment groups. Results. In the primary outcomes for infants, the review looked mainly at death and neurological outcomes. Overall, magnesium sulfate treatment had no significant effect on pediatric mortality, whether fetal, neonatal, or later deaths. With cerebral palsy as the neurological outcome, Antenatal magnesium sulfate treatments significantly reduced the risk across all five trials, with a relative risk of 0.68 and confidence interval of 0.54 to 0.87. Four trials, Crowther, Merritt, Rouse, and Magpie, reported on a number of other neurological outcomes. Substantial gross motor dysfunction was the only other outcome that showed a significant difference, favoring magnesium sulfate over placebo. Overall, there was no significant effect on the prevention of any neurological impairment, and other neurological outcomes, including blindness, deafness, developmental delay or intellectual impairment, and major neurological disabilities. There was no significant effect of magnesium sulfate treatment on the combined rate of death or cerebral palsy overall. However, we have to take note that the level of heterogeneity for the trials was quite high, with an I-squared of 51%. For the primary outcomes in women, there were no substantial differences between treatment groups and control groups in terms of maternal deaths, cardiac arrest, or respiratory arrest. In total, there were few women who had these outcomes. For the secondary pediatric outcomes, there was only a borderline statistical significance for a reduction in the need for ongoing respiratory support for neonates whose mothers had magnesium sulfate treatment. No significant differences were seen in any other outcomes, including intraventricular hemorrhage, periventricular leukomalacia, convulsions, hypotonia, and chronic lung disease. For the secondary maternal outcomes, as expected, there were significantly more women with maternal hypotension and tachycardia in the magnesium group due to the side effects. There were no significant differences seen for maternal respiratory depression, postpartum hemorrhage, and cesarean births. The five randomized controlled trials with 6,145 infants showed an absolute risk of cerebral palsy of 3.4% in babies exposed to antenatal magnesium sulfate therapy and 5% for babies unexposed, giving an absolute risk reduction of 1.6% in cerebral palsy. The number of women needed to treat to benefit one baby is 63, assuming a 5% cerebral palsy risk in the untreated group. Also, there is evidence of the neuroprotective benefit of magnesium sulfate therapy on outcomes of substantial gross motor dysfunction. The expected higher rate of maternal side effects with magnesium sulfate was observed, but major maternal complications were rare and not significantly different between the treatment and control groups.